We do talk about women empowerment, also about women safety. But actually what we do is just talk. Because when a person gets humiliated, there is no one who can support her, who can save her from that scenario, who can stand by her side and make her feel comfortable. Then why do we say that women's safety is the utmost priority? Why? Because words can be said to improvise women's condition. But when condition like this jumps on your head, you can't utter a single word. Why can't you do anything? Why? What happened? Are we here just to make statements to people which we can't even fulfill? Maybe that phrase, action speaks louder than words, is reciprocal and what we get it wrong. Because the right one is, words do speak louder than any other action. And that's what exactly happening in our society.
Kannada actress Samyukta Hegde has said that she and her friends were abused and attacked for working out in a Bengaluru public park wearing a sports bra by a group of people led by Congress leader Kavita Reddy. She alleged that girls were stripping in public and these uneducated blame people for unnecessary things. And if you think this is wrong, your upbringing is wrong. You are a primitive being. So instead of changing this society, change your mindset. Isn't the agenda of being feminist means supporting women to be something more than what the society frames them to be? Rise up and stand for the empowerment of every woman. There were men in the park who supported the statement of Samyukta. What does this show? It is very clear that the oppression of women in the society is not a gender problem, only but a majorly a mindset problem.
Regarding this video, first of all, this lady, Kavita Reddy, was repeatedly telling the police to take Samyukta Hegde and her friends to the police station. But what was the nature of the crime? Wearing short dress? Then let me remind you that the Indian Constitution provides right to adequate standards of living under Article 11. And clothing is a form of expression, power of singing, power of speaking. So these are also protected under the fundamental rights of Article 13(1)(a) of the Indian Constitution. And secondly, apart from Kavita Reddy, primary action should be taken upon the cops who are dancing at the fingertips of this lady who is a politician. Law is same for everybody. What about the social distancing norms? What were the police doing when a crowd gathered around the incident? What was the police doing when the main gate was closed? Hats off to these girls who stood against this all bravely.
On September 6, Kavita Reddy apologized for all this. But we are very sure she apologized because the tweets were shocking. She even tweeted that these girls were doing this for cheap publicity stunts. And Kavita Reddy says that these girls abused her. And she said this because just to take herself to a safer side. But she tweeted saying that these are D-grade actors. What do you have to say now? And from no way she compares Samyukta with Ragini. She was abusing these girls that they were involved in the drugs because of this controversy. But who the hell takes drugs early morning? And who has given a right to beat someone? These type of politicians are a threat to our country.
This is not the first time girls are being abused of wearing short dress. A year ago, a lady at a mall had abused few girls of wearing short dress. She also told boys to rape girls wearing short dress. Now, is that right? Dress doesn't matter. What is the fault of a 3-year-old baby or a 60-year-old woman? And in contrary, this lady was seen wearing short dress earlier. What a hypocrite.
Yes, wear the short dress or naked to rape.
Also, another incident happened in Bengaluru where a man accused a girl of wearing short dress. And he told the girl to wear a proper dress code according to the Indian rules and regulations.
Yeah, I've got the right to vote in India.
India, sir.
You are not an Indian. You're a dumbass person who doesn't even belong. I'll tell you what you are. You are not even educated. Where do you get educated from?
Brother, I am education.
So you stop your bike and tell a lady she can't wear these clothes. You are going to decide what she can wear.
Only I am requesting, please provide the Indian.
So Indian, so you are going to decide what she's going to wear.
Indian should be.
Well, what went wrong? I want to know what went wrong.
Please wear the proper dress code of Indian.
So this is an improper dress code that she's wearing.
Yes. I am absolutely telling. Please walk properly dress code for Indians.
Are you mentally wrong?
No, I am not mentally wrong.
You get treated.
Facts and regulations, I am begging.
Who made those regulations? Your dad. Because I know what regulations my constitution gives me.
Please.
Do you know what the Indian constitution gives? A freedom of choice, a freedom of wear
no,
anything.
Freedom is there, sir.
There is no Hindu in your constitution. There
no
are several.
Hindu.
There
no,
is
no,
nothing
sir.
Hindu
not,
in your
I'm
constitution.
Talking,
know
I'm
your constitution.
About Hindu and Hindu
just know your constitution, you idiot.
Sir,
first of all, get
Hindi.
In a bike and know your constitution.
Apart from all this, in another incident, a woman told Indians are not broad-minded enough to accept this Western way of living. Despite from all this, still, there are rules in Bengaluru how girls should dress. and colleges are major predators of this dressing discrimination. Many colleges don't allow girls to wear short dress even in their hostel. 6-inch gap in sari is culture, but 2-inch gap in jeans and t-shirt is vulgarity. Girls are taught not to wear short dress, but boys are not taught not to rape. Your dress provoke men is a moral crime. Remember, size of dress should not be the measure of the character. You'll tend to receive such humiliation until and unless people start speaking. So to everyone who's watching this, take a stand for what is right. Because if you didn't, maybe your close ones could be facing such a situation and then you'll realize, why didn't I do that before? Be different, make difference. You can bring the change and it is necessary. Remember this.